Teaching our children how to behave is one of the most important parts of parenting. But if you're finding it hard or confusing, you're definitely not alone. In this two-part series, we're going to give you a basic guide that can make this parenting challenge a little easier for both of you. Children begin expressing their emotions, needs, and wants from the moment they are born. By the time they're young toddlers, they are capable of making decisions to act on those feelings. Your role as their parent is to show them how to make decisions that will keep them safe and healthy, while also showing care and respect for others. Teaching your children good behavior should start with setting expectations. Here are some ways you can do that. Like all of us, our children's feelings are what drives their behavior. It's important to talk about feelings, to acknowledge them, and to name them. Talking about other people's feelings teaches your child empathy. It helps them learn how their actions can make someone else feel. It's also important for your child to recognize their own feelings. Remember, all feelings are okay, but all behaviors are not. Let's listen to this mom talk about feelings with her child.
You can be mad and you can feel sad, that's okay. But you can't hit a friend when you feel sad, because mm-hmm. that hurts them.
Mm-hmm. Another way to set expectations is to create family rules. You can remind your child of these rules while they're making a decision about how to behave. For example, you might say something like, "In our family, we use kind words." If you have a partner, take time to create these rules together and agree on how you will use them. Consistency with both parents is key. Children enjoy making their own decisions, and becoming independent is part of their healthy development. But small daily decisions, like what to wear or what to eat, can also lead to behavior challenges. Empower your child to make good decisions by giving them selective options. If you say, "What do you want for a snack?" the answer might be jelly beans, and then the power struggle begins. But if you ask, "What would you like, a banana or a cheese stick for a snack?" you're giving them the ability to make their own decisions, but either choice will be a good one. When children are doing something they shouldn't, especially if what they're doing isn't safe, it's easy to say no, just to get them to stop. But the word no doesn't give your child information to help them make a better decision next time. Use descriptive words like "ouch" or "don't touch." After you have their attention, explain a little more. You might say something like, "Wait, I need to hold your hand before we cross the street." If you're thinking, "Okay, I've set consistent expectations, but my child is still misbehaving, now what do I do?" watch part 2 of this series and we'll talk about discipline.